These are the best highlights from the matchup between T1 and BLG during the quarterfinals of the 2024 Esports World Cup.
They go for a late invade towards Ona's jungle, and I don't think Ona has any idea what's going on here. We'll see that ward go down. Probably knows that something is up here as Elk and On moving into the Sejuani's jungle, and Ona is going to have to get out of there.
With Elk being up here, it's a lane swap Atlas that we're going to see here as On and Elk head topside. This is going to put Bin in utility position here to try to deny Ona the flash.
That's a big flash forward. A bit weird because Elk not there, but it doesn't actually matter. That's first blood going to On, taking matters into his own hands.
Owner in the jungle will just go straight over to his blue buff, and Ben decides to back and teleport to the bottom lane. As you can see, already some damage done to that turret by Guma and Carrier, but the Kai'Sa isn't going to wreck turrets too quickly as
Yeah, Carrier already taking a bit of damage here, but they're just going to claim themselves a kill as Bin possibly regretting the teleport option.
Yeah, well, that's a huge huge win here for T1 on the other side. So
I think that is still going to be the case for Zeus in this game, just because if he gets all outed, he then just has a very comfortable way of getting back out of the situation, as Extendo Beam is going to do a bit of damage here onto On. Grasping Roots not really connecting there as Faker gets rid of Knight from that mid lane. A bit quiet in the mid lane, as it were, going to look like, as BLG look to take the first dragon of the game. Looks to be uncontested here as well, as the Chemtech Drake is going to be taken down. So first one going to be a Chemtech, second one going to be a Cloud. So no Cloud Soul. I'm a bit sad about that, but that's fine. Don't get everything. There's a flash from Ona. Gets the flash out of Shun here as well, as Faker avoids the Strangle Thorns. Shun going to get rocketed in the face, and Faker is going to be able to grab that kill. Now T1 moving ahead in the kill score and
trying to push out this top side, but Guma can clean that up. Zeus will match the Kassante push bottom side. I think Bin picked up a plate or two. Yes, he did. You can see him picture in picture there. Nice attempt at steal by Elk, but he's in trouble.
Yeah, going to be out Arcane Shift out as Ona just Arctic Assault away. So not wanting to greed for the final grub. And so that is going to be a pretty even trade between the two, as you can see at the top of the screen right there. Three grubs apiece.
Faker crushing the lane, but he is winning Corki versus Tristana, somewhat of a rarity in the LCK. As you can see, Carrier and Ona are looking for potential picks. Shun.
Yeah, Ona moving on over, finds the Glacial Prison there as they at least manage to land the Strangle Thorns. But Zeus will come over and just executes the Zyra Cordoner jungle.
Point here for T1. If they give two dragons, that is potentially going to be a big problem if the soul is relevant with Chemtech already there. Big chance.
Yeah, Zeus once again going to be ulting. Ona moving on over as Bin's going to have to flash this time, but the Arctic Assault will still collect the knockup. And Bin, nowhere to go, no chance. And Zeus, he gets another one. And Wolf, are we getting towards certification territory?
Yeah, I think I'm ready to stamp it. I mean, two kills to this area in the top lane, and it's a bit of a puzzling choice. I mean, Bin just greeting super hard for plates there, sticks around. They have no control over the Dragon Pit. Now they have even less, as there's wards everywhere. Is they're going to try to make a topside cross map here onto Faker. He's got Flash and Valkyrie.
Yep, Depth Charge going to start this dive up. It's a fantastic Valkyrie to get Faker out of the way, but I don't know whether he's going to survive this one. There's the Strangle Thorns, and there is the kill. It's all the sacrifice from Shun. Is that an execute or was that actually a kill? I didn't actually see it. My brain didn't process it.
I think it was a kill.
2-1-0, so I think it was a kill. So yeah, just a 1-for-1 100
to his name.
And I've seen this one before, Wolf.
And the value isn't as pushing up.
We're dashing over the wall here. Is Zeus Gumushi gonna come down as well? There are too many AD carries in this game. The Rift Herald will be taken here by BLG, but they'll have to sacrifice Bin for it. Zeus taking a fair bit of damage, but is ultimately on a killing spree at the end of it. So Rift Herald collected here by Shun. We'll see whether Bin's sacrifice is going to be in vain or not as they get to work on the top side of the map.
Zeus should be able to finish off this turret. I mean, the first of the game before that Herald gets dropped. I mean, they have a three grub answer in return, but with Carrier here, setting up a dive is going to be so tricky. They don't even commit to it. It's trying to find Ona or anybody here, but they're already caught.
Yeah, Glacial Prison comes down, and once again, Shun's just going to explode. No way out, and they are picking on this extremely squishy Zyra.
Will go down. So Faker and Carrier getting themselves some plate gold, turret gold here towards the top side as BLG once again roaming up, but perhaps a little bit too late here as Carrier is going to get missed by the hook, but still, they are going to get there. The Eclipse is eating a fair bit of this, but still, Shun is going to be able to grab the kill onto the Leona. BLG answering back, trying to take whatever they can here on the rift that is left for them. Bin taking some damage from Zeus once again, but he's just going to dash himself away. Doesn't want to mess with this area at all. Finally, the Herald maybe going to get something done here in mid lane. Still a pretty healthy turret.
We'll see how much they can take out their whole group.
Yeah, that is going to be a bit of an interruption here as Shun is able to land the Grasping Roots onto Ona. He's going to flash, gets himself out of there as Faker teleporting right into the thick of things. Zeus has turned up as well, and Faker kind of frontlining on this one, taking Mystic Shots. True Shot Barrage is going to get flashed by Faker, and that is a good amount of respect. That thing does so much damage.
Great usage of the hair. BLG will be able to take this one away. A great play. It's all set up. Oh,
whoa, that's a flash. Gumiushi going to have to flash in response as well as Carrier. Just a little bit late to the play, and that is going to be out of turret in mid lane as well as that dragon. And BLG fighting back brilliantly, also getting some space here on the bottom side, and it feels like the tempo has shifted so quickly in favor of BLG off the back of that Herald.
The Observer showcasing how little vision there is here for T1. Even the Ezreal ult is significant poke here.
Oh, yeah.
And Elk is just kind of playing with his range advantage right now. Zeri, fairly low range, obviously, outside of her Extendo Beam. But Elk can continue to push these waves through. And T1 just aren't able to skirt around. And this buys enough time now for the Dragon start for BLG. So Tristana, another power of Tristana, she can do Dragons very quickly with this Zyra. T1 will clear vision, but they don't have the speed to trade this. So they're unfortunately just going to have to give the Dragon up. But it's just been mid-bio that T1 has been so far behind on. You can really feel the weight of the lack of teleport here for Zeus in this game.
No, I agree. I actually think that it's starting to become a little bit of a worry. The apprehension that you're sensing here for T1.
T1 are in a great position. Three items Zeri, but we're just not having a straight up 5v5 fight. BLG are not allowing it.
Yeah, Ona now possibly out of position. Does have Carrier there, but there's no real damage follow up unless they can create some plasma here for Gumiushi to react to. There is a snare, and the Void Seeker not going to connect. Hook as the re-engage does come in. Glacial Prison is decent, but the shutdown onto Zeus immediately, and BLG, they might use this to start off the Baron. At least Elk, that's what he's decided he wants to do. Still, Void Seeker is going to make it seem like it may not be the best decision to make, and BLG looking for a turn instead. More poke coming through here, as the more you hit, the more you can throw. Gumiushi still just firing.
Continuing to control this mid lane, out pushing the Kai'Sa consistently as he just offers more and more poke. Even with True Shot Barrage, you can see these Qs really stacking up.
Yeah, well, another Glacial Prison goes down here as Faker just gonna grab that kill onto On, and as we praise him, we cast a curse him. And he is gonna be taken out there. So one killed on the side of T1 into one killed on the side of BLG. BLG weren't able to push Drake. You know, not the end of the world. T1, they cannot afford to. Giving away three Infernals and Soul is just kind of ridiculous. As T1, you can see, positioned to try and take this one down, and they're gonna be fighting for the death for this one. As let's see who's going to be able to take it here. Shun taking some poke damage, and these Void Seekers also starting to do a fair bit as well. The rotation around from the Zeri, but the Dragon is down very, very low. There's a Killer Instinct. They take down the jungler, but can they win the fight is the question. That's the Dragon secured for T1. Carrier is just taking Bin for a ride, and the rest of BLG are just melting. Now the top lane is going to do battle. Yeah, Bin's going to win those as he walks into melee range of the Kassan. Still, it's going to be a one-team fight, and still T1 are going to look the first target here for T1. There's an inner on the top side of the map as well, but to really open up the map, it has to be through mid.
It does have to be through mid.
Yeah, we'll be taking down some of these wards around the map. Shun going to get slowed down. There's a Glacial Prison as well. Special delivery of Gumiushi with the Killer Instinct, and there goes the Zyra. Massive tanking being done here by Carrier, but can't tank absolutely everything in the kitchen sink. And so he will go down, but jungler for support, you take those, especially if you get a turret along with it.
Absolutely, and that's just gonna allow Zeus to push this top lane. One single pick, again on the jungler, six deaths on this squishy Zyra.
And after such an incredible early game as well, as Bin is gonna find the knockback onto Ona, but skating on in is Zeus. Bin now just gonna have to book it out of there. On in so much trouble, walking the wrong direction. Ona gonna finish him off. And T1, they're starting to knock them down now, starting to get a feel for how this game is moving closer and closer to a victory for them. And they'll push this wave towards the inner turret and really expose BLG's side of the map now.
Yeah, we'll see if they can actually grab this inhibitor with the last 30 seconds of the Baron. They really want this.
Yep, Solo sure. Going to set up for the Zenith Blade. It's a decent Strangle Thorns, but he's still going to go down. The follow-up just not going to be there. Another Glacial Prison. Great buffer there from the Tristana, but Knight not able to offer any damage back, and that's going to be base broken by T1.
I think they want more.
Yeah, they ain't stopping here. There is still 15 seconds on this Baron buff. They're going to take at least one of these Nexus turrets as the minions are starting to run out.
G sitting here on their Nexus. And T1 still trying to push forward. Carrier, not sure about that one, but I like the gusto. Has been in a whole host of trouble. Faker taking matters into his own hands, but not enough damage to kill the Cassante just yet. Turret shots just raining down as Elk landing these pot shots and starting to make these health bars look a little bit lower.
Oh, the teleport flank from Bin.
Big old flank from Bin as he dives in towards Onar. I don't think Onar's too worried. The all-out does come through. If they kill the Sejuani, it may not necessarily be end of the world. 53 seconds.
...to trade for, but it looks like with no prio, no teleport on Faker, they're just going to opt to give this up. And I can't blame them for the choice. They have mid control with the inhibitor down. They can maybe grab a second one. That's the goal here, if they can get it down quickly enough. But I think trying to walk head first into that BLG composition without prio was just not going to be a successful strategy. They won't get this inhibitor binged. Here we go.
Extendo beam, not quite going to land there. Neither is the Glacial Prison as BLG able to get themselves out of there. Bin at about 50% health, but he's the tank. He's not too worried. Solar Flare also not exactly hitting the sweet spot as Shun able to walk that one off as well. Still T1 winning in the damage trades.
Yeah, if you can hit every single Void Seeker onto squishy targets like Shun, I mean, this is going to really start to stack up. Corki Poke, not as strong as it used to be, but still relevant here as T1. I mean, the weight of the wallets, you can really feel it. Shun just trying to back away, get some healing. They're going to start the Baron. It's going to have to be a clean engage from On.
Yeah, there's the flash forward from On. Speaking of which, True Shot Barrage over everyone as Zenith Blade in the backline just to try to get rid of them. And now Gumushi, that killer instinct really working out. Faker dashing in. It's a little bit split, but it's working as Gumushi flashes over the wall. There's the double kill. T1 dealing with Bin on the top side. Zeus not going to be falling this time around. And T1, it's another team fight, and this one could be the end of the game.
Looks likely that he won away in the first game of the World Cup.
That's a big old flash forward as Knight's gonna get slowed down. There's the Glacial Prison. Set him up and you knock him down. Carrier and Ona with some great initiation in this game. And there goes the first Nexus of the EWC League of Legends. T1 going to claim it. And BLG gonna need to win the next one to stay in it.
What a game to start it off. Top Zeri.
These were some of the best highlights from the 2024 Esports World Cup quarterfinals matchup between T1 and BLG. Which moment was your favorite? Let me know in the comment section below. This is OP, and I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.